Okay, I'm done with my silly dancing. I don't know if you wanted to join me. I hope you did. But I just got finished with a really big deal for me, a big part of my master's. So I am really close to being done. I'm feeling so good and so excited. And so today I'm going to share, it is Pilates and planks. So a lot of plank-based exercises. Oh, I'm out of breath just from dancing. This shows how bad my cardio is. And so anyways, I hope you enjoy. Let's get started. So the very first thing that we're going to do is, again, kind of a foundation type exercise. So I'm going to start with your knees bent up, standing, or not standing, sitting nice and tall. Your arms will go out in front of you, and then we're going to place them down towards your knees. Going to go back, all the way back, until your arms are extended. So you want them to be totally straight. Once you've gotten to this point, so we're going to hold for a bit. Make sure that your back is still nice and long. I'm already starting to feel this and shaking a bit. Then what we're going to do is lift one arm up. Ooh! And down. Other arm up and down. Let's do it again. A couple more here. One. Two. One. Two. And come all the way back up to your straight seated. Whew. Can roll those shoulders back a bit. Take a nice deep breath. And we're going to go again. So, roll all the way back down until the point where your arms are nice and extended. Once you've got here, we're going to bring both arms up. And then all the way down. Both arms up. All the way down. Two more times. Up. And down. Up. Oh, and down. One arm up, down, other arm up, down, and we can come all the way back up to seated. Okay, so here what I'd like for us to do is, I'll show you this little ditty. It's before we get into our actual plank, so I kind of want to do an opposite motion. I'm going to place my hands down here. And what you're going to do is you're going to straighten your legs, make sure they're together, pointed forward towards the wall or the sea, a beach, I don't know. Your hands are facing forward and you're just going to lift your hips up towards the ceiling and continue to try and stretch your legs out forward. So we go up. You can let your head hang back here, just looking up at the ceiling. Don't want it to go too far back, just kind of up ahead as well is fine. Hold here for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1, and bring slowly back down. So you should start to feel the front of your arms and a bit of the back of your arms here working. Oh, you're of course using all your backside here to lift yourself up too, so getting nice and strong. Let's go again. Up. Hold. I've extended myself a little bit more here. We hold here. If you want, you can look to the right, look to the left. Make sure that your neck is not tight. Bring it back down. Let's go again. Up. And hold. Here, if you like, you can try and lift one leg up a little. Point. And down. Other leg up. Down, next leg up, you can see I'm shaking, up, down, and now let's bring ourselves all the way back down to the ground. You can release your wrists, because mine are definitely feeling pretty tight. We'll do one last one, make it a good one. Your legs are nice and tight together, you're trying to use your bum to lift yourself up too, and going all the way up nice and strong. So you're making one strong line. A couple deep breaths here. slowly roll all the way back down. Once you've got here, again, you can release your wrists, shake those legs out a bit, and then kind of lean up and over all the way forward. I have got really tight hamstrings. I've said that before. So I always pretty much have to bend my legs, but that's fine if you do that. Go ahead and stretch. Hang on in there. Nice and good. If you'd like, you can kind of move your legs out a bit and then just try and go ahead forward for a nice stretch, trying to kind of do the opposite of what we were just doing. Releasing here. And finally, what we can do is just go into a nice child's pose. I know, I'm giving you a child's pose really early in this workout. So, a nice stretch. Couple deep breaths here, we'll do three. Two. And three. Okay, so we're done with workout. Sorry, we're not done with the workout. We're done with our warm-up. Now getting on to the workout. So next up, what we're going to do is going to go ahead and do a classic plank. The way I like to get into my plank is that I first have my hands just below my shoulders and making sure I'm getting nice and lined up. And then I do start in this bent knee plank. I find that it really helps with my alignment from my lower back to my bum and my glutes, because otherwise it's really easy to kind of go like this or maybe too much like that. You want a nice and in between. So I stay here, get myself all settled, and then I'm going to lift one leg up, other leg up, and we're just going to hold here. So we're going to try and take nice deep breaths as we're doing this, but also keeping your belly button in and glued to your spine as much as possible, which I know sounds crazy, but you're going to try and do it. You don't want your belly hanging all the way flat or flabby, because if you do, it's defeating the purpose. The idea is that you're using your ab muscles against gravity, and that's what's strengthening them. So a few more deep breaths here. And with each deep breath, you can really bring that belly button in towards your spine again. Two more. Okay, so you can go onto your knees, release your wrists again. Nice little Arabian dance move, and we're going to go back down into plank. So we get back into our plank position here. This time, and again, I didn't mention this, but if you'd like, you can have your legs a bit wider. That gives you a more stable base, or you can go together. It's a little bit harder, less stable base, but either one really is fine. So here what you're going to do next is I'm going to actually have mine a little bit wider, and I'm just going to drop one knee down to the ground. One like this, back up. Other knee, back up. Touch, up, touch, up. And I'm really starting to feel this already in my arms. Ooh, and just my whole spine. It's feeling really lengthened here. Up, let's keep touching. Or down. I'm saying up as I'm touching down. Here we are. Let's do two more on each side. One, one, two, two. All right, bring those toes together, knees down, and release. So for this next one, what we're gonna do is similar, but I'm gonna have you bring your legs together and you're gonna touch both the knees onto the ground. So just a little variation of what we just did. Take a nice deep breath, get back into position. Lengthen out those legs. We're nice and strong. And here, just gonna touch both knees and bring it back up. Touch. 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 as you lengthen back out, really thinking about, again, keeping your core and your arms strong. This is a full body move here, so you will definitely feel it probably everywhere tomorrow. And actually a lot in your back, I'd say, in a good way. One more. Just getting one more after this. And all the way back down. Ooh, I love that. I'm really feeling it actually here in my shoulders. Again, should be so nice for the summer. I keep talking about the summer, but I really feel like it's coming. I'm just looking outside my window now. It's a beautiful day, and I know it's coming soon. Okay, so here we're gonna go into another plank position. And here what we're gonna do is, well, I'll show you. Legs are gonna be about hip width apart for this one. What we're gonna do is point your right leg and then bring your knee in towards the center. So, like this. And back out. Only gonna do four of these. The goal here is that you're using your abs to bring your leg in and not your leg or your hip flexor so much, okay? So we're gonna do three more. Two more. And for this last one, try and go slower than you initially want to go, okay? So nice and slow, pointed all the way in. Hold. Back. Legs down. And a little rest before we go on to the other side. Okay, so you should definitely be feeling warm by now, I'd say. It's crazy because that one, you don't think it'd be so hard, but at least I feel like it's pretty good. Okay, on to the left side. Deep breath, pointed toe all the way in. Ooh, feel that. So you're using your lower abs to bring your knee all the way in. We've got two more here. Up, last one. All right, go all the way back down now. Come into child's pose. We deserve this. Oh yeah. So here in child's pose, you can bring your knees out wide and stretch out your arms or curl out your arms like this. Get nice and low so that your bum is coming towards your heels and you're getting a good stretch across the lower back. Oh. Let's take four deep breaths here in your own timing. So go ahead, just listen to your body. Each breath, just feeling your belly fill nice and full, and then relax down into your heels. Okay, so that was my last breath there. So next what we're gonna do is our last just kind of, straight plank exercise, and then I'm gonna go on to a side plank variation. So here what we're going to do is we lift up into plank, all the way up. Here your legs are going to be together, it's better this way, and you're just going to tap to the right off of your mat, tap to the left off of your mat, right, left. Keeping your core stable so that you see that my body's not really moving too much. Oops, sorry, going to lengthen out here, but other than really my legs. Keep breathing here. It's really important, of course. And it actually really helps deepen your muscles and your abs again as it's doing the workout. If you really want to ramp this up, you can kind of do boop. I'm not going to do it because I don't feel like ramping it up. So otherwise, you just keep doing as I am doing here. A couple more on each side. Let's say three more. One, two, three, and we're done. All right. So next what we're gonna do is we're gonna go on to a side variation. So the first thing is called diagonal. I don't know if it's actually called that. It's just kind of what I call it. And what you're going to do is put your hand here, facing towards the front of your mat. You will have, let's say that we're going to put your top foot just a little in front of the other. If you want, you can do one on top of the other directly, but I feel like it's more stabilized this way. So you're going to go like this, and what your goal is, let's see, actually, I'm going to turn mine facing towards the front, so put your hand facing towards the front. And what you're going to do is lift this arm all the way up to the ceiling. Can't even see my hand now, but it's there. And I'm going to push yourself up going diagonally, okay? So in this direction. One, two, three. And as you come back down, it's this diagonal thing. It's not down here. It's actually staying towards your feet. And up. And up. Taking nice deep breaths and making sure that you really are staying on this diagonal so that your abs, your body is facing forward. A couple more here. This is really going to help with your obliques, so your sides, giving you that nice small waist. Just two more here. Oh, one, two. I'm a liar. Let's do one more. Three, hold, and bring it all the way down. Oh, I love that. It feels really good. Okay, so I'm going to go on the other side. Just bring your legs around. First hand facing towards the front of your mat. Top leg is going to go just a little in front of the bottom leg. Going to do the same motion on this side. So my arm goes all the way up to the ceiling. And I'm going to go ahead and make myself do a little diagonal. Actually, I'll move back so you can see me a bit better. And we go. Here we are. While you're doing this, you can be thinking of different things. Maybe having some ice cream later. Or having a really nice glass of red wine. I think that's the one I'm thinking about. my grandma's homemade pasta. My mom's homemade pasta. Can think of something else to try and distract yourself. But again, the goal is that your waist is staying nice and lifted here. And then doing this diagonal motion. Let's get about three more here. Two. Keeping your body nice and stabilized. Three. I want one more. Four. All right, hold, and we can come down. Excellent. So we've got another variation of this similar thing. Gonna go on to this side, but I like to call this one the rainbow. So what you're gonna do for the rainbow is, again, you're going to go ahead and put your arm out. I should have mentioned this with the last one too. If your wrist is really hurting, you can completely come down like this and do a similar motion. I'm sorry I didn't mention this earlier. It's just a slight variation. Still gonna work, okay? So for this rainbow exercise, you can do the same thing. You can come down here if you're feeling like your wrists are hurting, okay? So for this one, again, you're gonna have your legs layered. They can be totally on top of each other or one in front of the other. I think for this one, I'm gonna try on top of each other. And actually, let's see, I will try. I'm going to give it a go. You lift your hips all the way up, and the goal is to make a little rainbow. And then dip them down. And a rainbow up. Woo! Actually, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and put one leg in front of the other. It's easier. Lengthen, come down. Nice big rainbow. Again, trying to keep your hips facing forward so they're not changing or turning too much. Then lifting those hips up towards the ceiling for a beautiful rainbow. Let's do two more. Last one. Gorgeous rainbow here. Hold. Wiggle those fingers. You can look down at your hand. Back there, and all the way down slowly. All right, so we're gonna go ahead and do the same thing on the other side. All right. So starting in the same position, again, you can fit them on top, one in front of the other. I'm gonna go for one in front of the other. So you saw how miserably I failed on the other one. So arm, actually we'll bring it up as we go up. So first you're gonna bring yourself up here. Arm is gonna arch. All the way down. Well, not all the way down. A bit down, a few inches down. Give yourself that nice little rainbow. Oh, I love this because I think it's so pretty. Makes me feel like a dancer almost. Can imagine that your hand, as it's making that rainbow, does have paint again smudged on it. Doing this side, I think a bit slower. Can pick up the pace if you'd like. Let's just do three more here. One, two, three, and one last one. Ooh. All right, hold there. You can look up towards the sky, down low, and all the way down. Oh, wow. Really starting to feel this, it's so good. all right, we're almost done here. I'm just gonna make us do the very last one, which is swimming. And I think if you've seen one of my videos before, then you'll remember what it is. It's our very last one. Before we do our final push-ups, because I always like to end on some push-ups, okay? So here we're gonna go onto our belly, a nice relax after kind of a lot of work, right? So we come back down here, laying nice and flat. And can you see my whole body pretty much? What you're gonna do is extend your arms out, extend your legs back, making your toes just point towards the back wall or wherever. What you're gonna do is lift those guys up just a little, lift your head up, arms up, and then you're going to pretend that you're swimming. So you can do this a bit slowly at first. Lifting opposite arm and opposite leg up. Your head is just kind of looking a little out in front of you. And then if you'd like, you can try and go a little faster. As you're doing it, the goal is really not to make yourself rocked side to side. You're trying to keep real good equilibrium. Wow, I'm feeling it already. And then kick and pedal for your life. Oh, you're in a swim competition. You're about to win that Olympic medal and just go. Woo. Couple deep breaths here. Last one. Hold. Hold up for two, three, four, five. Oof. And all the way down. Ooh. I'm so tired. All right, our very last move is going to be push-ups, like I promised you. If you'd like, they can be real push-ups or they can be on your knees. Today I'm gonna try real push-ups because I'm feeling very frisky. So I'll go ahead and stay like this. I'm gonna bring myself forward a little bit. And I like to keep my elbows in rather than the wide arm push-ups. Two. I'm only gonna make us do seven here, okay? Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Ooh. Let's do two on the knees. Bring your knees down. Two more. Eight. Nine. I'm a liar. Let's get to 10. 10. Push all the way up. All the way back. Oh, child's pose. Couple deep breaths here. Okay, and come all the way back up to seated. Let's stretch our arms all the way up to the ceiling. All the way down. And you did it. You made it through Pilates and planks. Yay! Okay, I hope that you have a beautiful day and I hope to see you very soon. À très vite. Bye.